You're listening to The Minstrel Show on World United Music in Montreal. I have a special feature today on David Roberts. And no, he's not the David Roberts everyone knows. This is an unknown David Roberts. And he's a folk singer. And I'd have to say unknown folk singer, because I looked around everywhere for links, and I couldn't find any. The only place I could find a link for him was on Amy Street, where I found him. And you can find that, of course, on the World United Music blog under David Roberts. Anyhow, David Roberts is the kind of folk singer that brings back the craft of the minstrels of old. Today's songs, Last Stand of the Giants and Christmas 1943, will fill you with the wonder of a craft long forgotten, but hold you emotionally with the message passed on. Here is David Roberts.
Just set, and I'm filled with regret. Some things are hard to believe, but as the time flows, the old ones must go, and we are left to grieve. Who cares for the littlest creatures when their homes are one day razed? Who sings where the songbirds are sung and people once came to pray? Who sings where the songbirds have sung and people once came to pray? Voices so weak, they barely can speak, so few to tell their tale. The powers that will the machines to be still are deaf to their cries and wails. The earth must be conquered, subdued for our use, the prophets seem to agree. So we stumble blind without looking behind at destruction born of our greed. We stumble blind without looking behind at destruction born of our greed. Sky, calling God to hear. A voice on the wind calls him again, a song of hope and fear. They whisper, we are the heart of the ancient earth, the seed for the world to come. Let the wind in my hair blow everywhere, soon we will be gone. Let the wind in my hair blow everywhere, soon we will be gone. Soon we will be gone. Soon we will be thank you. just 5 days till Christmas, 1943. Bombing raid completed over Bremen, Germany. A man of barely 21 was flying all alone in a crippled bomber struggling to get home. There was a big hole in the port wing and the tail was all shot off. One engine had quit running and it was tough to stay aloft. But in that cold gray emptiness of that fearful bloody dawn, Franz Stiegler had them in his sights, bent on doing harm. Approaching from behind them, Franz thought about the fight. For 25 planes had met their doom beneath his deadly sights. But as he drew in closer, the vision brought him pain. A dead man in the rear gun of the plane. The top turret was all frozen, and the gunner paralyzed. The pilot just sat trembling with terror in his eyes. For a moment, Franz flew silent, then looked at them to say, good luck and make it home, boys. And with a wave he flew away. What happens to our hearts when the Christmas spirit's near, and the many deeds of the passing months seem all that much more clear? When the madness that surrounds us and holds us all in fear is set aside this holy time of year. Well, the bomber made it back that day, and those who were alive never would forget that day as they went on through their lives. But 40 years would pass before this story was uncovered. Each was driven then to find their German brother. Well, Franz was living out his life, no special claims to fame, when the bomber crew paid a visit after finding out his name. They shared with him their gratefulness, and several asked him why. But something in their visit brought tears to his old eyes. For each one carried pictures of the loved ones they had raised. 25 precious children, one for each burning plane. What happens to our hearts when the Christmas spirit's near, and the many deeds of the passing months seem all that much more clear? When the madness that surrounds us and holds us all in set aside this holy time of year. What happens to our hearts when the Christmas spirit's near, and the many deeds of the passing months seem all that much more clear? When the madness that surrounds us and holds us all in fear is set aside this holy time of year. Is set aside this holy time of year.